Halloween in Toronto, just about 25, 30 minutes up the road from where we are in suburban Mississauga, Ontario, Canada, as we welcome you back to Skate Canada, the men taking the ice now for their short program. And here are the Grand Prix standings after one event. Timothy Gabel, the upset win at Skate America, picked up 12 points. Todd Eldridge, the bronze medal. Right now, he has 7 overall in the Grand Prix. Hi again, everybody. Terry Gannon, along with Peter Carruthers. And Peter, look at Alexei Yagudin, what he comes off of at Skate America, the upset loss. The only positive thing to take away from that is that it was a non-scoring competition. So he lost nothing in the standings, but right. He knows he's got to turn it on now.
Well, he was totally exhausted at Skate America, upset by Timothy Gabel. He said, basically, all I could do was survive Skate America. Here he's got to get his jumps back on track and show some energy in his skating to get the big scores that a three-time world champion like himself can get.
Todd Eldridge, a third-place finish at Skate America, but a gutsy finish. He injured his back in practice, fought through it, so an impressive performance from him. Different situation here, though.
Well, Todd Eldridge's coach, Richard Callahan, put it real simply. He said, this is like starting over. Todd Eldridge is a world champion, but he has got to be aggressive. He's a great competitor and certainly one that can step up to the plate and deliver the goods. But right now, here at Skate Canada, he's got to prove that to the judges once again.
Well, here are the 8 required elements here in the men's short program. It's 2 minutes and 40 seconds in length. And remember, it's worth 1/3 of the overall score. And the men's short program gets underway with the 3-time national champion of Japan. And he is still only 19 years of age, Takeshi Honda. And when he is on, he is very, very good. Talented skater. 10th in the world at Nice last season.
Very solid choreography in this performance. It's all about putting the jumps and the spins together to make it great. Right away, his quadruple toe loop.
Ooh.
Flipped out on the second jump. Unfortunate, because he started off so good.
This season, of course, the first in which a quad is allowed in the short program. In combination, and we've seen it a number of times. It was allowed last year by itself.
But there, nice triple axel. Not getting distracted at all. And that small mistake.
Well, Peter, he may be from Japan, but got a lot of fans here in the Hershey Center tonight. He lives and trains in Barrie, Ontario, just a little over an hour from here, and coached by Doug Lee, who coached Elvis Stoiko and Brian Orser.
Again, leaning and flipping out that awkward position on the landing. He's capable of better than that, and he knows it. That'll cost him. That program has so much potential. Paradura from Don Quixote, hard to skate to it, but I've seen him skate very well to it in practice, not his best here. The mistake showing up on those incredibly difficult jumps.
Saw the grimace on his face as he ended his program. I think more in relief than anything else that he got this thing out of the way. Got to be frustrating to be able to do it in practice all the time when the lights go on, not be able to do it like he wants to. But not a bad start for Takeshi Honda.
Quadruple toe loop, triple toe loop combination. This one was perfect. And then he just doesn't stop the rotation on the second jump. Looking in close at the feet. Look at that foot vault him up into the air. That was fine, but it's what's going on right here. Nice tight position with the legs, but it's the body that's starting to lean that will take him out of this jump and cause the deduction. Now he'll skate into this triple Lutz with footwork, have to precede it with footwork. And again, that same flipping forward, he's got to be angry with that.
There'll be two sets of marks, as always. The first four required elements for Takeshi Honda. There they are, 5.0 to 5.2.
Disappointing, but you can just see how you're taxed when you make those mistakes. He knows it. He's capable of better. I've seen him do it much better.
And the marks for presentation 5.5 up to 5.7, Peter.
And these were, that program from a presentation standpoint is excellent. Really make it grow from here.
So Takeshi Honda at least has to be happy with the presentation marks here in the short program. When we come back, the 20-year-old from Peoria, Illinois, Matt Savoy, skates when we come back to Skate Canada.
Our next competitor representing the United States, Matthew Savoy.
Welcome back, everyone, to Skate Canada, the men's short program continuing inside the Hershey Center here in Mississauga, suburban Toronto. And here's one of two Americans taking the ice here, Matt Savoy, the 2000 junior world bronze medalist.
Now he's got an opportunity. If he can get out here, skate without mistakes, he may find himself higher in the standings because he doesn't have the same difficulty, but it's all about not making mistakes on the technical elements. There's a nice triple axel. His combination will be the triple flip. There's the first jump, followed up. Oh, no. Only did a single toe loop, short of rotation.
Matt began his junior year at Bradley University in the fall. He's from Peoria, lives with his sister and his mother, who happens to be a librarian at Bradley. Had an excellent year on the Grand Prix circuit last season, a fifth at Skate America, and won the bronze medal, a surprise finish at Nations Cup in Germany. But this is a whole new season.
Interesting position on that spin. Again, waiting for someone to really step up here and deliver a performance without mistakes.
Good comeback, though, for Matt Savoyk. Had the problems early and at least kept his composure.
Absolutely, and again, some nice innovation on the spin that we saw. Had a good reaction from the audience, and the judges like to see something different.
Finished just off the podium the last 2 years at the U.S. National Championships.
Cruise through the first jump, the triple axel, just fine, but this jump, you need to really plant the right foot in, use it like a pole vault to get up into the air. That was fine, but then this, a single toe loop. There's 3/10 off the mark.
Linda Brannon's been his coach since he was 9 years old. The first set for required elements, 4.7 to 5.2. And Peter now for presentation. There are the marks.
And his presentation was much better as far as the second mark is concerned.
Wide range, though, from the judges. Matt Savoy into second place right behind Takeshi Honda right now. Well, he's fixing his hair because you're going to hear every young girl in the audience. It's going to be like the Ed Sullivan Show back when the Beatles were on. Right. Fedor Andreev, who is like in sync up here in Canada. He's got such a following, and they say he has star quality, only 18 years of age.
Got the Tom Cruise lookalike going there.
The 99 Canadian Junior Champion.
Triple combination will be the triple Lutz, triple Tolu. Now he steps up and delivers the goods very well. Double axel. I think what Fedor has going for him is he's got a good balance of athleticism and artistry.
He's got the genes too. His mother happens to be Marina Zueva, who is best known for her work with Gordieva and Grinko. Constantly looking for the next Elvis Stoiko here in Canada, and there are many right now who think this young man fills the bill.
I'll tell you, he's got a lot of ability to perform to the music and really bring nice choreography to that and bring out a good character on the ice. Very talented.
He's not the only one standing right now either. A standing ovation here in the Hershey Center for the 18-year-old from Ottawa, Fedor Andreev, who they predict big things in the future. Two back-to-back Junior Grand Prix event wins last season and a fifth-place finish at his first Canadian Senior National Championships.
Gets up into the air just fine on this triple Lutz and then follows through to the triple toe loop. No problem. Good way to start.
Set now for required elements. That's a wide range.
And this audience certainly doesn't Appreciate that.
Wow, all over the place. 4.4 to 5.3. There's his mom, Marina Zueva.
Low scores, but what I'm looking at is what he's got behind his skating outside of the required elements, and that's the presentation, and these should be better.
Well, they're better, but again, they're all over the map. 4.7 to 5.5, so Andreev in third place behind Matt Savoy, Takeshi Honda in first right now. Up next, the 96 world champion. He's back. He's skating brilliantly so far, and he'll take the ice when we come back. Todd Eldridge comes up next. Your top three right now, Takeshi Honda, Matt Savoy, and then Fedor Andreev. As the short programs continue with the five-time U.S. champion, 29 years of age, Todd Eldridge, who has been skating competitively for 18 years now. The back is not 100%. It stiffens up on him, but he says he's fine to go.
His strategy here will be not to put the quadruple in the short program. He wants to skate a program without mistakes, and it begins right here. His opening combination, triple flip, triple toe loop. Nice and clean.
Again, if you're in the top three, the way the scoring breaks down, you go to the free skate. If you win that free skate, you can win. You are the overall champion.
And that's exactly what his thinking is. And that's why he's saving the quad for the free program.
Mm-hmm.
Nice and low on that sit spin. And look how he spins right in one spot. That's what allows him to spin as fast as he is.
With emphasis at the end.
I'll tell you, this guy has got to feel pressure to skate well. Every time he's really under it, he rises to the occasion. He is superb.
Able to see his folks here. They've come to watch him in suburban Toronto. Todd Eldridge, you look at Richard Callahan on the left, his longtime coach. And Eldridge, just a remarkable career. And to come back, the 96 world champion. No sign of any back injury tonight.
Two things to look at. Look how low he goes, and second of all, he's in one spot. Judges really appreciate the strength it takes in his quads to be down that low. Fantastic.
Richard Callahan, Todd Eldridge, Olga Volonchinskaya, his choreographer. Boy, what a night for Eldridge after the disappointment at Skate America because of the collision, the injury, almost withdrawing. fought through to gain the bronze medal, but this is why he came back, and always with an eye on the 2002 Olympics, of course. Required elements, 5.5 to 5.7, Peter.
Very solid marks in terms of them being in line. Remember, no quad. Yagudin yet to skate.
But I have to leave a little bit of room, perhaps, when Alexei Yagudin goes out and attempts his quad. Presentation marks 5.6 up to 5.8. Todd Eldridge into the lead.
Our next competitor representing Canada, Ben Ferreira.
So it's Eldridge, Honda, and the young American, Matt Savoy, your top three, as one of the crowd favorites from Canada takes the ice. Ben Ferreira, the 21-year-old from Edmonton. Ben won the bronze medal at the Canadian National Championships last season. Finished seventh in this event a year ago. Ferreira, at the age of 11, watched Kurt Browning's performance at the 91 Worlds and said, yep, I want to be a figure skater. Wonder how many young men in Canada did the same thing during Kurt's career. Back in 96, Browning himself said that this man could be the next great Canadian figure skater.
To the music, not only is he doing the elements, but sensing the music and the timing that you need to skate to it and interpret it.
Now, a lot of people have felt the pressure up here in Canada over the last 5-6 years of being that next great skater, at least the label. Andrea, we've seen him already. Emmanuel Sandu, who we saw at Skate America, and Ben Ferreira, all feeling that pressure of a great legacy of skating here, at least with the men north of the border.
Just makes the sport better. Triple axel, always a forward takeoff on this jump. And then the vault up into the air for the double toe loop.
So now the marks. First set 5.0 to 5.4.
With marks that are in this range, it doesn't put him in a real competitive situation. And now the presentation.
5.2 up to 5.5. Maybe better marks than some people expected in this audience. You hear the kind of applause there. Ben Ferreira into third place right behind Honda. When we come back, the reigning world champion tries to right the ship and get his first win of the season. Alexei Yagudin is next.
Alexei Yagudin.
Back at Skate Canada, Terry Gannon, Peter Carruthers, Todd Eldridge in the lead over Takeshi Honda and Ben Ferreira, But here comes the three-time and reigning world champion from Russia, Alexei Yagudin, coming off a loss at Skate America in the first Grand Prix event. And unlike Eldridge, he does have the quad planned in this short program.
That comes up first. He hit this perfectly at Skate America. The first jump. And really struggling. You can see how that curled around the corner on the second. Not a good setup there.
Alexei Yagudin may have been happier than anyone to leave Colorado Springs, which is better than a mile high. The altitude, as you mentioned, took its toll on him. He was scared to death to go out there and skate the long program. Much different case here in Canada for a man who did not have an easy season last year, even though he won his third straight world title. A loss at Europeans, the loss, the Russian National Championships. Already this season has lost to Timothy Gabel. The only man he lost to last year, Yevgeny Plyshenko.
Like you said, I think he was just glad to get out of Colorado Springs, but I see there's a fundamental problem with his quadruple toe loop in the beginning of the program.
Todd Eldridge was brilliant a few moments ago, backstage, waiting to find out what the judges think about Alexei Yagudin, Peter.
Absolutely. But I'm really curious to see what he's going to do from here on in with his quadruple jump, because he skates it so close to the boards. Today after practice, I asked him, why do you take this quadruple toe loop so close to the boards? And he said, because if I keep it in the middle of the rink, I'd start swinging my legs and I can't get the rotation I need. But I think he gets spooked being that close to the boards, and that's what happens when you are in that situation. Again, pretty good here, but then he's so close, he's curling it around the corner so that he can do the second jump. He's a little bit distracted. Needs to clean that up.
The Yagudin camp very focused now. Tatiana Tarasova and Nikolai Morozov along with him as they await the marks. Todd Eldridge watching the monitor backstage. What do you think, Peter?
Well, I'll tell you, I thought Eldridge's performance was sharper than Yagudin, and here are the marks.
Well, Alexei reacting, I think, there to the 5.4, the low mark.
Yeah, but they're mixed here.
And for presentation now, 5.6 up to 5.9. He thinks they're so-so, an indifferent reaction from Alexei Yagudin, but good enough to put him into the lead ahead of Todd Eldridge. And the reaction from Eldridge, well, still in the top two. I'll go to the free skate, at least in the top three, and move on from there. So six of the nine judges place Yagudin ahead of Eldridge, who is in second place. Takeshi Honda in third, and a great short program for Matt Savoy, the young American who goes into the men's free skate in fifth. And make sure you join us for that.
Harry, Todd, great short program. What is it going to take to beat Yagudin in the long?
I don't know. Seems like everybody has trouble with that. But no, I'm going to try the quad at the beginning of the long program. And then, you know, if I skate a good, clean long program, then I'll be happy. And, you know, if I beat him, I beat him. If I don't, then, you know, doesn't matter if I skate a good long.
Well, good luck. Take care.
All right, Susie, thank you. That'll be a great finish to the men's competition here at Skate Canada on Sunday. When we come back, Anasina and Pesara, the reigning world champs, take the ice. The original dance is next from Mississauga.